Hello everybody, welcome to my third lesson on PHP and MySQL. As I told you, we are going to refresh a little bit your HTML and CSS knowledge, skills. We don't have a lot of time, so it's going to be quick, just basic terminology, as much as we need as PHP developers. Obviously, HTML and CSS, it's a big topic. It should be another course. So just the main concepts, the main terminology today. And what you see here, my WAMP server is working. You see the address, localhost, lesson 3, little boy, HTML. So it's a small poem, nursery poem. It's a very simple web page. And I'm going to analyze the coding, how it is done. By the way, going back to HTTP transactions, surprisingly enough, but this page needs more than one HTTP requests and responses because it has graphics. So first, browser asking for the HTML document. Apache server send back to the browser HTML. Then browser realize there is graphics. So browser sends second request to the Apache server. Apache server is sending now graphics back to the browser. And finally, you see a small icon in the left top corner. It is also picture, so it has to be delivered to the browser. So even this very simple web page needs three HTTP transactions, three requests and three responses. Now let's take a look at the coding, how it is done. HTML is language of tags and elements. However, let's not confuse. In many books, unfortunately, tag and element terms are mixed up. They are not the same. I'm going to clarify the difference. HTML element and HTML tag. So HTML defines the content of your web page. In HTML, you define as a developer what you're going to publish. In CSS, you define as a developer how you're going to publish. So HTML what, CSS how. In CSS you specify colors, spaces, alignments, and layouts. So it's very advanced language and they work together. HTML it's like a basic language, CSS is additional language. And technically speaking, you can create web pages without CSS, just in HTML. However, in real life, it is it never happens because you need to make it attractive, and that's why CSS comes into the play. So HTML element consists of opening and closing tag and the content. For example, here is one HTML element. So opening tag, content, closing tag. So tag and element is not the same. This particular element has opening tag and closing tag. Some elements require two tags, opening and closing, but some elements they just have one tag like image. You see, image doesn't have closing tag, and that means you cannot insert in image element another element. But if your element has both opening tag and closing tag, you can put inside one element another element. Look at the lines 13, 14, and 15. Inside paragraph element, I have B element. Inside B element, I have I element. B is bold, I is italic. So keep in mind, there are two types of HTML elements with two tags, and some of them, they just have one tag. Sometimes you use inside opening tag so-called attributes. So attributes, it's additional information embedded into the opening tag. For instance, this is one attribute, this is another attribute. So img element has two attributes. By the way, I don't have here very popular element, hyperlink, A. So hyperlink, it's very popular element, it's connection to another page, and I don't have it here. So the most popular elements are, as I said, hyperlink, A, heading, big text, H1, H2, H3, H4, A5, A6, we have 6 H elements. Paragraph P, break, BR, I don't have breaks here. But of course there are more, I don't want to get into details. In general, probably we have around 15-20 most common HTML elements. So the language is quite simple. HTML language, quite simple. Much, of course, simpler than PHP. Okay, now, if we're talking about attributes, the structure of the attribute is the name of the attribute, equal sign, and the value of the attribute in quotation marks. So this is standard syntax for any attribute. So elements may have 1, 2, 3, the unlimited number of the attributes. Some elements, as you see, don't have attributes. It all depends on your concrete situation. Attributes are additional information embedded into the HTML element. And attributes have names and values. Values are always in between quotation marks. CSS, cascading style sheets, second language. You specify appearance your web page in CSS. So you specify colors, background colors, space between elements, borders, the size of the text, alignment. So it's like publishing system, how you print, how you want to show your web page. And there are three types of styles. So you can make styles inline, internal and external. Inline is when you insert style directly into HTML elements. And that's what we are going to use in our course. So for us, for PHP programmers, probably we don't need internal and external styles. We need just inline. We are not designers, we are programmers, so inline style is embedded into element as attribute. You see here, style is part of my element. And this is style declaration. You may see a few style declarations in one element. For instance, I have two style declarations. One, two. The declaration consists of property and value. This is the name of the property. This is the value of the property. You see the syntax is a little bit different from attributes. In attributes, you divide name and value using equal sign. In CSS, you divide the property and the value using column. And you separate different style declarations using semicolon. So this style says, please put the image to the left side of the web page so that text going to wrap around my image, and make the right padding 10 pixels. So if I don't specify this, what's going to happen? My text going to get too close to the image. So this is padding 10 pixels. Because all the elements are related, connected together, technically speaking, for each web page, you can draw a tree relationship how HTML elements nested. And I can show you the tree for this web page. So HTML is the root element, the main element of the web page. Inside HTML, you must have two elements, head and body. But all the visual stuff getting here. So body is the biggest element of your web page, because everything you put basically here. You see only title. Title is part of my head. But images, paragraphs, bold, italic, it's inside the body. And you see parent-child relationship. So nested elements, they are explained here in this simple picture. It's a tree, and if your element has two tags, you can put inside something else. If your element like image doesn't have two tags, only one tag, you cannot embed, you cannot insert. So this is the end of the tree. I think in mathematics we call sometimes elements branches and leaves. So if it's a branch, you can have another branch, but if it's a leaf, it's finished. So tree cannot go any further after image element. So one more time, look at the web page. Look at the coding. This is, by the way, not element. It's just a declaration. I am going to follow the latest HTML5 standard. I have to have HTML element and then head and then body. So you see sometimes you made a mistake, but browser still handle your web page properly. So HTML element, very important. It's the root element of your web page. Everything belongs to HTML element. And now you see head element, title element, And you see big body element. It has a lot of stuff inside. So thank you very much for watching. Next lesson we start learning PHP. Have a good day. Good luck.